Shalom, Rastafari. Greetings, brothers and sisters. We're speaking on this heightened state of alert and giving a warning and a call to repentance for Ethiopians at home and abroad in light of the recent and ongoing, actually, developments, the beheadings of the Ethiopians, they say Ethiopian Christians in Libya, as well as many other outrages, atrocities, murder, and violence against Ethiopians at home and abroad, and black people and the lost sheep of the house of Israel in general. And they're so lost that they don't even know that they're lost. And that is what makes matters even more difficult. Now, the recent message that was signed with blood was directed to the nation of the cross. When we think about the nation of the cross, we have to ask, well, what nation are they speaking about? It's like when George Bush Sr. spoke about one small country. No one asked what country he was speaking about, but there's a sign right there in that. What day was it on? It was 9/11, and 9/11 is Ethiopia's new year, and it's very clear from the message. Ethiopia and Ethiopian Christians must abandon the false images that they have of Jesus and Mary that have crept in recently and have totally overshadowed the true images of our Black Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and his mother. And this is what we want to bring to you right here, right? Let's bring this up right here. So this is what's going on, brothers and sisters. And I have pointed this out in previous videos. And in light of these recent reports, such as we have right here, a message signed with blood to the nation of the cross. So which nation are they speaking about? And which cross are they speaking about? Well, this is the cross that is being spoken about right here. This is Lalibela, right? And now many will say, well, this is from fascism to Islamofascism, right? That's also a subject matter that we'll like to unpack as well. And hopefully in tonight's Testify Tuesday, y'all willing, we'll have a time and opportunity to address that on the air and in the spirit with the brothers and sisters. And really look at homeland security, our homeland security. But there first must be a repentance, right? There first must be a repentance. And this is why we focus on the image, right? And they're worshiping the image of the beast, right? This image right here is a false counterfeit image. And we ask, well, what is behind this recent and severe and very violent and graphic uptake in the violence against the Ethiopians is because many of the Ethiopians are in a state of apostasy and carelessness. And there's still much that is, there's much that's good. I don't want to just say that, you know, we're not talking about all. Many know about this, but many refuse to address the counterfeit images which have crept into the sanctuary. And therefore, this has weakened Ethiopia and the righteousness of the Ethiopians in responding to this bloodshed and mayhem. But let's ask, well, what is behind, right? What is behind what we're seeing, right? And we know that there's a lot of deception that is going on, right? There's a whole lot of deception that's going on. Well, here you can see what and who is behind this attack against the Ethiopians. This is another part of the secret Jesuit wars. The secret Jesuit wars that are going on within that region. Now, we can get into the details of it, and we have addressed and touched on the details of it, but we want to show you exactly what's behind, right? What is behind the attacks against the Ethiopians? What is behind, and who, more importantly, who and what have the careless Ethiopians done to compromise their faith and ability to get up and stand up against the violence and mayhem? It is the creeping in of the counterfeit Christianity, right? It's the creeping in and it's the denial. We showed you this before. Right, let's show you this again. Right here, this is what's going on. Let's show you the cover right here. We're going to have to do an update to this as well, right? It's the secret Jesuit wars in Ethiopia, right? What's behind the so-called ISIS, right? The ISIS. And that's the Roman ISIS you see right there. Actually, it's Lucretia Borgia, right? Caesar Borgia's sister. And this is where we get the image of the beast that's mentioned of in Revelation, as well as the image that provoketh to jealousy, according to the scriptures and in the Bible. And this counterfeit image has crept into the holy places within Ethiopia. And this has also compromised the grace, right, as well as the protection, right, as well as divine protection has been compromised. And this is why you're going to see an inability, right, of the careless Ethiopians to stand up to this attack, right? This is not just a physical attack. This is a spiritual warfare. What are you seeing with the beheadings? Well, that's the physical part of it. And now what you're seeing with the response, that's the psycholo-